Hello friends, welcome to this talk on the new education policy 2020. The policy aims at ensuring in the entire education system, starting from the school education to higher education, few concepts which are extremely important, and these are equity, access, quality, inclusion, affordability, research, innovation, accountability, etc. And of course, technology. So, in a sense, I would say that the new education policy 2020 is a continuation of the earlier policy of 1986. The earlier policy also talked about equity, access, and inclusion. Now, when we talk about access, equity, and inclusion, all of us know that the entire open and distance learning system in this country stands on these three broad features: that we want to democratize higher education, we want to take education to the doorstep of every person in this country, and we want to reach out to the unreached. This is the basic philosophy of open and distance learning so far in this country. And the new education policy very clearly talks about this. They say that access to high quality education at the school level and at the higher education level has to be ensured through a new system of education. Of course, they add that along with access, inclusion, equity, we should also ensure quality. So when we talk about the role of open and distance learning in the new education policy, I would say that ODL will be renewed and expanded. It recognizes the role that open and distance learning in this country has played so far, whether it is NIOS at the school level, or the Indira Gandhi National Open University and the state open universities at the state and the central level, so far as higher education is concerned. It also says that people residing in rural areas, in remote areas, in backward regions, people who are economically poor, people who are differently able, for them, open and distance learning and online learning are the best platform for education. The document admits that both ODL and open online learning are natural path to high quality education. So therefore, through ODL and online learning, you will increase access, you will ensure quality, you will democratize education, and at the same time, you will reach out to the unreached. One good thing that the new education policy talks about is that the entire higher education system will have multidisciplinary higher education institutions, not the compartmentalization or classification of central universities, state universities, regular universities, open universities. Instead of that, it says that there will be multidisciplinary universities in the country, and every university will have the scope and the opportunity for providing either online education or education through open and distance learning mode, provided they are accredited by the Accreditation Council, National Accreditation Council for the purpose. So it is now online learning and digital learning and open and distance learning is open to every institution, and every faculty member has been encouraged to provide e-content or to prepare high quality e-content. Along with their classroom notes and classroom teaching, they are also encouraged to provide high quality videos, they are encouraged to provide high quality content, and these contents and videos, e-content and videos, should be available in the public domain so that teachers and learners or students will have access to that. So the institutions, the teachers and the students will have access to technology. They will have access to good quality software, and they will have access to the text content as well as the video content, so that you can say that education has been truly democratized, or the access to education has really been created. But one concern which the new education policy has definitely said is that such content, such videos should be of high quality. The education provided through online mode or through the open and distance learning mode should be of very, very high quality. And for that, there has been an institutional mechanism which has been envisaged in the National Education Policy document. The National Higher Education Regulatory Council will prepare the standards, the norms, the accreditation principles for education provided through either online mode or through the open and distance learning mode. Similarly, the General Education Council, or the GEC, which is one of the verticals out of the four verticals recommended in the new education policy, will also prepare guidelines for ensuring quality of open and distance learning programs and programs offered through the online mode. So I would say that there are great scope for open distance learning and online learning in the new education policy at the higher educational institution level, either at the school education or higher education, or at the adult education or vocational education, and use and integration of technology with ODL program has also been envisaged. So all of us who are great supporters of ODL programs and ODL methods in this country should feel happy and encouraged that the new education policy has really supported our cause, that this 50% gross enrollment ratio, which it envisages to be our target to be achieved by 2035, can only be possible if online education, open and distance learning, along with regular mode of teaching and learning, will be combined and will work together for achieving that goal and that mission. Thank you very much.